to the slide Get Tech Simplified video. Have you ever wondered, how can you add a guest user to your Azure AD environment? Well, look no further. This video, we're gonna cover just that. So make sure you watch this video until the end. Creating a guest user is really easy with using Azure AD. The first thing you have to do is go into Users and click on Guest Users, and Microsoft provides you with two different options. You can create a user using your organization's domain address, but in this case, we just want to invite a contractor in to be able to collaborate with my team without having them to assign them a license. Instead, they could just be one of our guest users within our tenant. I'm gonna go ahead and update all this information. So you're gonna hear some nice, cool music while I'm typing through this. So let's go ahead and get that started. Once we create that account, it's going to send us an email with an invitation to join my organization. So go ahead and click this link. And now it's going to say, hey, you want to give read permissions and take a look at what permissions you're going over. Click accept. It's going to ask us, hey, you're going to need some more information. So let's go ahead and provide them with that. So let's go receive notifications, set up. I'm gonna scan this with my cell phone. In my cell phone, I'm clicking work in school. I'm gonna scan it. Click next. It's gonna check the verification status. And once this loads, this should give me my next steps for what I need to do next. Let's click next. I'm gonna hit the test one, hit approve, click done. Now it's telling me to sign into my account. And now I got access into my actual single sign-on portal. If I had some applications, it would show up here if I allowed this user to see any of my corporate applications. So take a look how easy that was to create a guest user. It didn't have to create your own account for them. You can use their current credentials, user from your environment, and you don't have to go through the lengthy process of taking them out, all those different groups.
Now you understand how to add a guest user in your Azure AD environment. Next thing I need you to do is make sure you continue to watch all the other videos in my channel. And if that's not good enough, make sure you subscribe and click the bell to stay notified, because I release new content each and every week. So until next time, Sly Gittins is out.